Well, folks, it's time to kick it old school. So you can feel cool. Give it to me, baby. Baby. Yeah.
What's up, guys? Welcome back. I lost my juice. Welcome back to Maestro Vapes. All right, we're about to ring in the new year, so I thought what better way to do it than, you know, have another vlog, have some drinks along the way. I probably had a couple of shots already. I just want to talk about some of the stuff that made my year better than it was before, you know, and some of the stuff that I really liked, you know, mods and addies and juice and stuff like that, that I really dug throughout the year. Gonna be drinking some Don Julio. They're not paying me for this, but I'm gonna be drinking their tequila. I'm about two shots in right now, and I'm gonna try and have at least a half a dozen through this. So I don't know, it might get messy towards the end of this. I'm kind of nervous about doing this whole thing right now. So cheers, my Finnish friends. Kippis. Pretty smooth for a tequila, man. Like, the premium tequilas are really good. Really good. No, I'm not that far on yet. Maybe towards the end of this. You know what? There's a lot of stuff that I dug this year. And you know what? The channel's grown. You know, the first video that I shot was like New Year's Eve of 2013. So today marks 1 year since the first video that I shot. So I'm pretty stoked, you know, and I want to thank everybody who's been along for the ride, you know, throughout the year, or even, you know, if you've been along for the ride for like 3 weeks or 3 months or whatever, I really do appreciate the support, guys. Thank you so much, you know. I think it's important to tell the truth about stuff that you like and don't like, you know. That being said, there was some stuff that I got this year that I didn't do reviews for. You know, there was some stuff that either I thought was the biggest piece of shit and I didn't get around to reviewing it, or I didn't dig it, you know? So what were some of those things? Fogger. Fogger V4 was one of those things. I got one, didn't review it. Why didn't I review it? The Fogger V4 was cool, but the fucking thing didn't have post holes in it, you know? So I did not review it. Some other stuff I didn't review. I didn't review the Orchid when I got it. It's the version 2 Orchid, and I dig it. And the reason why I didn't review it was I felt like there was enough reviews. Like, I felt people had reviewed that thing to the gills and put builds in it, and those builds were good, you know? So why shoot another one when it's already there? You know what I mean? That's just how I feel. Another thing that I didn't review was the Hexome. This is the version 1 Hexome. I got this thing at the beginning of August. Had problems with my original one. Sent it back. Some of you guys will remember that. I sent it back. It took like 5 weeks from the time that I got it to get it back. And when I got it back, they were announcing the version 2. That was about to drop. I think that dropped in September. So I didn't do a version 1 video, okay? But all in all, the Hexome is a good little box. Like, it does what it's supposed to. It's got some build limitations, but it works. And for stuff that I like this year, this is up there. This is up there, and I dug this. I used this quite a bit over the last few, I don't know, 4 months, I guess, 4 or 5 months, and it worked well. Let me have a vape. Maybe we should talk about some of the builds. People are yelling, have a shot. Have a shot, right? Okay, Don Julio. Have a shot. So this is going to be, fuck, my fourth one. I'm drinking these, like, quick, too. Like, I did two before I started this video just to see if I could handle it. So, you know, here's my second one of the video, fourth one of the last 15 minutes. Maybe I should just pour one for just to be ready. Damn, this is going to be a crazy video. Maybe not. I got a chaser too. I'm chasing the Fresca. got some Fresca in you. So that, I, you know, I didn't review that. Other stuff, what didn't I review? I did a lot of reviews, man. I think I probably did the better part of 100 reviews and tutorials and stuff like that this year. Like, I'm not quite at 100, but I think it's like maybe 90. Maybe this is 90. Who knows? But yeah, I reviewed a lot of stuff. What didn't I do? If stuff broke, there were a lot of clones that I got that I didn't touch. You know, like I didn't review like Patriot clones, and there was an Omega clone that I broke immediately. What else? And if it was just weak sauce, if I felt like it was just weak sauce, I didn't review it. You know, I didn't want to say, hey, check this out, because people might think like, oh, you got one, maybe I should get one, you know, and that's not the case, you know. So if you didn't see it, it was probably for the better, you know. I want to do best dripper. I kind of want to do best dripper just to knock it out of the way, okay? Because I think that's one of the most important things for me this year. Dripping was my year. You know what? I drip probably 95% of my day, you know? Like, even when I go to work and I go out, if I have an appointment somewhere, I'm dripping. Like, I drip. Like, I bring a bottle and I drip. That's just what I do. Starting from earlier on this year, Patriot, by far, at the beginning of the year, Patriot was my favorite atomizer. Patriot version 1. Patriot version 1.2, loved that thing to death, man. And I drilled that thing just to the gills, you know, and loved it. Got the Patriot version 2, and I like it. You know, I like the version 2 Patriot, but I still like my version 1.2 better. That might be weird, but I just do. I think I'm going to actually drill out my version 2 Patriot to a much bigger hole. Like the top cap, this captain cap has like an 11/64th hole. I think I'm going to go to something like that in my Patriot version 2, and it's going to make me love it again. You know, I think that's really going to do it. Speaking of the captain cap fits the tugboat. Now, the tugboat was one of my favorite atomizers of the year. I love that thing to bits. I've got a couple of them. I got the version 1, the version 1.2, I guess it is. The 1.2 with the copper post in it. That was just the best, you know? And I drilled that thing only out to about 3 mil, 1/8 airflow holes, and it was boss. Like, it was so boss. But, you know, over the last little while, I've kind of put it away a little bit. But I got the captain cap. This is AmeriVape. Okay, the company that you love to hate, everybody hates. I tell people I like AmeriVape stuff, and they're just like, dude, really? I'm not going to watch your videos anymore. But anyway, the captain cap by AmeriVape. This is the Mod Men Green Edition. It's got the Mod Men logo on it. Love this thing. Breathe new life into my tugboat, and I just... fuck, I dig it. It's so good. Man, those shots are starting to warm me up right now. Man, Sasha might get lucky tonight, man. Anyway, the tugboat is definitely up there. Love that thing to bits. Patriot version 1.2. Up there. Big time. What else? Oh my god. The Tobe. This is the version 2.5 Tobe. I had a version 1 Tobe, or was it the version 2? Version 1 Tobe, I think. And that thing was boss. I have no idea where it is. Somebody has it out there. I don't know who you are, but you've got my Tobe. Either way, no big deal. But I got the version 2.5 Tobe in the summertime, and it blew my head off. I just love the way that it works. You know, there's a lot of atomizers being made, but I think everybody kind of tries to replicate the Tobe deck, you know, because the Tobe has been done. It doesn't get much better than the Tobe, you know, and the version 2.5, I've got the Chuff top, and the Chuff drip top on this is just beautiful. Like, I haven't drilled out those holes anymore. On the 2.5, the holes got a little bit bigger, And it's just perfect. You know, I've been thinking about putting two more smaller holes above those holes just to see what would happen. But I'm kind of partial to that because I like it the way it is. And I'm almost nervous that I would, you know, louse it up enough that I wouldn't dig it. So I've left it. You know, it's one of those atomizers that I feel this dripper is going to stand the test of time. And I really, really dig it, man. Jabo, you are the man. He's probably not watching my videos because my videos are probably lame to that dude. So there's those. Flavor addies. I'm not big into them. Like, I'm big into stuff that I can push clouds out of and get good flavor. Like, there's a happy medium that I like. The Quicksilver RDA made by Two Puffs. That was pretty friggin' good. The guys at Dash Vape, Shy was cool enough to let me use one of those. And actually, we gave it away in a giveaway there. You know, Mr. Pedius won that thing. And I hope he's digging it because I thought that was a really good atomizer. And for a long time, I was thinking, dude, keep it. Just keep the hattie, you know, and I didn't. But, you know, it was free to me, so it was free to somebody else. But the Quicksilver was definitely one of my favorite flavor addies, okay? Doge Mutation X Wars went on this year. Fuck, I don't even know where I'm at. Five now? Chaser. Doge Mutation X battles went down. I preferred the Doge. I had the version 2 Doge, or, you know, the second run of them, second round of them, whatever. And I just liked the Doge a little bit more. The Mutation X, I had some problems with it. If you saw my video, it wasn't super positive for the Mutation X. And when they launched the version 2 Mutation X, those screws, man, just kind of ruined it for me. Those triangular screws ruined it for me. Next one, the version 3 Mutation X, I think is going to be awesome. You know, but this one, not too amped about. People were asking me if I was going to get the Doge X. I am not going to get the Doge X. I'm not going to get the Doge X to review, and I'll tell you why. Here's a little trick that you can do. If you like the Doge deck, which I do, you can take your original Mutation X sleeve or barrel, whatever you want to call it, and put it on your Doge deck. You can do it. You just have to build your coils a little bit higher. Bam. If you do that, you have a Doge X, in my opinion. You know? And I've done that. I've done that before. And then I was watching a video with Leo Shim, whatever your name is now, and he was doing that. He was using that deck with that, you know, barrel, top cap, whatever, from the Mutation X. And I was like, sick, you know, like great minds think alike. And I'd only done that like 5-6 days before that or something. And he was doing it. And I'm like, dude, you're genius, man. That's why I dig Leo's shit. Awesome. So Doge, definitely, in my opinion, was a better atomizer. Okay. No Doge X coming up, no Mutation X version 2 videos coming up. I'm not going to do them. You know, that's just me. Mutation X for me is still kicking. Like, it's still kicking. And the way that I like to use my Mutation X is on, like, a regulated box or even on the Hexal. I can build the Mutation X. And this is weird for me to say because I think I'm probably putting my foot in my mouth, maybe not on the Hexal, but using, like, let's say the IPv3, all right? Using the IPv3, I can do a build on the Mutation X that's like 0.2-ish, you know, around 0.2, maybe 24 gauge, maybe even a 22 gauge build with a lot of wraps. And I can get a decent vape once I hammer up the voltage. You know, once I hammer up the wattage, I can get a decent vape on it. But if I build it to like 20 gauge builds or like parallel 22, something like that, it's brutal. So there's that. Doge was able to handle my builds a lot better. But I did go through the first insulator pretty quick. Like that kit you get, it comes with, you know, a spare insulator, spare post and all that shit. And that's awesome. Conger Vape, good on you. It would be nice to see more people do stuff like that. But yeah, I'm kind of low building my Doge lately because I don't want to kill the insulator. So I'm doing like builds on it that are maybe like around 0.1 ohm on a single coil build. And I'll show you one a little bit later because we'll talk about builds and I'll show you a build that I've been digging. So there's that, you know, whatever. Kind of a weird segue on those, but I guess it applies on a volume vaping channel. Yeah. What else did I love? The tugboat was great. 454 big block. This was like the flavor one for me. And it busts clouds huge. And for me to tailpipe this thing, it's the most comfortable tailpiping addy that I've used this year. This is a quad 26 gauge Campbell build. Comes in around 0.12, I think. No, it's higher. Sorry, man. Sorry. I think it's around 0.15. It's around 0.15. Fires on the Sigelli 100 watt. I'm hitting it at 80.4 watts, and it's brilliant. Just, this build deck was great, and it was like a step in the right direction. With that ring, I still build underneath the screws, and that's what I dig, but the 454 big block was definitely my favorite all around addy. Like dripping atomizers all around, good flavor, massive clouds. I was building that thing out to 22 gauge G-plat builds that were coming in at 0.07. And I take like an IGO W, what are those plastic caps, whatever they are. And I drill holes out into it, like 6, 12, 24 airflow holes into it. And just bust clouds out of it. And it was the best thing. Biggest clouds I blew this year. 454 big block with an IGO W cap that was drilled all to shit. It was ridiculous, the clouds that I blew on that. It, you know what? The Doge could not compare to it. Mutation X could not compare to it. My next addy that I'm going to talk about could not compare to it. So one of my favorites, 454 big block, you know, the authentic. I don't know what the clones are like. I have not tried them, okay? I'm vaping this a lot, though. And why is the build? One of the reasons is the build, and we'll talk about that in the build. And this is going to be quite a long video, okay? My favorite RDA of the year. Although I haven't tried the Eric, I didn't try some of the stuff that's coming out. Like the Derringer looks kind of neat for flavor. I think that might be a pretty boss addy. If you like the Tobe, I think you might like the Derringer. But I'm not sure. You know, it's it looks neat. But segue again. Getting kind of halfway buzzed here. Favorite atomizer of the year. Dark Horse by Steam Angel was my favorite addy. I rock this thing full open. I don't turn the airflow control upside down to close any holes. It's just as wide open as you can hit it. And I love it, man. This has been, you know, my addy for putting my favorite build in. You know, my favorite build this year was probably, honestly, is a simple build because it's easy and quick. It's the 20 gauge dual coil. Whether it's Canthal or Nichrome, it doesn't matter to me. You know, if it's Canthal, I do 4 wraps. If it's Nichrome, I do 5. And the resistance ends up being about the same. It's about, you know, 0.08 to 0.09. And I love it. That's just my jam. So typically I would put, you know, a 20 gauge build in here and let it rip, you know, just let it rip. And use that big drip top, and that is my shit. Although I did put a different build in this today, or actually yesterday, that I've kind of been messing around with and I'm really excited to tell you about, but we'll talk about it after. Let me hit it, man. Wow. The Dark Horse. Oh, my God. Has been my addy since everybody told me to get one. Like, everybody said, get a Dark Horse, try the Dark Horse, whatever. And I said that in my Dark Horse video and in another vlog. But I did. I got one. And when I got it, I wasn't too amped on it. I thought it was kind of tinny. You know, I thought it was kind of tinny. The build quality, I felt like it wasn't awesome. I thought it was like a Zenith. You know, that's what I thought. But the more and more that I used it, it became like I was inseparable with it. I had to vape the Dark Horse, and it was like my main addy. For the last, I don't know, 2 months, I guess, I haven't been able to put the Dark Horse down. Like, it is my main thing. And if there's been like a moment where I haven't had a vape, and like sometimes at work I don't have a vape for like 3 hours or whatever, I pick up the Dark Horse, and that's the first thing I go to. You know, everything else comes secondary. You know, even if it's, you know, the tugboat with the captain's cap, which I love a lot, good vape. With a Monster Tiger build in it, just one of the best vapes I've had. This could have the most simplistic, you know, straight contact coil build, and I'm vaping it. You know, and that's, it's just the way it is. The airflow just works. You know, it's got like three different slots, smaller, medium, and large. And I feel like it draws differently. Trevor Jones put it well in his video for the Dark Horse, that he felt like it just draws a cyclone just because of the way the airflow is lit up. You know, and I think he's right. It just works. It's simple. The build is easy. The post holes are big. You don't have to mess around. You don't have to continuous strand build it like I did a lot of continuous strand builds this year because it was hard to get two pieces of 20 gauge in something. It was hard to get a Tiger coil in something, you know, with two pieces of wire in the positive post. And this just, you didn't have to do that. You know, I still did some of those builds, but I found the conductivity with the way the screws go down on the post, whatever, it was just perfect, you know? So, Dark Horse, Steam Angel. Man, I would buy, like, a Steam Angel hat, like a Dark Horse hat, and wear it, because I'm, like, super huge fanboy. Super, super huge fanboy of the Dark Horse RDA. Oh, yeah. But it's so, like, it's so good. If I suggested one RDA for people to buy who vape like me, you know, like, if you vape 24 gauge, even 22 and 20 gauge builds, or you vape, you know, Clapton type of Tiger thick wire builds, I would suggest the Dark Horse. Like, that's it. Like, that is the jam. Like, that is it. Let's do another shot, man. I think it's been a while. Anyway, Happy New Year, guys. I hope you know, I wish you all the best in the new year 2015. Success, happiness, health, whatever you want this coming year. If you want to lose 20 pounds, or you want to buy a new car, or you want a better job, or you want to take steps in the right direction to, you know, start your own painting business or whatever it is, I wish you all the best. But at the same time, my New Year's resolution is just to get off my ass and do those things that I want to do. Okay? That's it. Maybe you might not see me on the internet as much because I want to do the things I want to do. But cheers. Very good. We'll do mods, then we'll do some builds and juices, and I'll get out of your hair, man. Start of the year, my favorite mod, man. H Cigar Nemesis Clone. This was it. Like, I won probably 3 cloud competitions using this clone. You know, where there were people using nice shit and expensive shit. I showed up with, like, you know, a $40 H Cigar clone and beasted, you know, and that was my jam. And my year was, started out with like 20 gauge builds for clouds and then went to like parallel 22. And right now it's kind of, I don't want to give away my secrets just in case. I'd rather just judge cloud competitions and be in them. But yeah, solid copper contacts, solid copper body. This thing just works and it never stopped working. The only thing though, man, it's kind of a pain in the butt with the, you know, the Nemesis clone or the authentic Nemesis. This is the authentic that I'm vaping, copper Nemesis, is you've got to keep these clean. The contacts need to be very clean on these to work well. All right. When I'm vaping my authentic copper Nemesis, or when I was vaping my H Cigar copper Nemesis, I mean clean. Like, I mean, you got to clean those things every couple of days, you know? And, you know, last couple of days I've been off work and I've been vaping my copper Nemi, the authentic, a lot. I got to take it apart and at least clean the bottom contact, you know, every 2 or 3 days to get a wicked hit off of it, you know? Like, I'm vaping dull batteries on my vlog, man. What the fuck, dude? I'll segue once again. Another cool thing that I dug this year, Samsung 25Rs. What a beast of a battery. You know, when we were coming out of a Sony VTC shortage and people were paying ridiculous amounts of money for Sony VTCs, like, I saw people spending like $20 on a battery. I was like, fuck those batteries, man. Like, they're not that good, you know? The Sonys were great batteries. They held up really well. If you saw my last vlog, like the original Purple EFES, the 30-amp EFES, were VTC4s, you know? Like, and they were cheap. They were cheaper, you know? But since then, I've become a Samsung 25R dude. They hold up to everything. Excuse me, everything that I throw at them, you know, every friggin' thing that I throw at them, the Samsung holds up to. I've built very low. Like, I've built as low as, me personally, 0.06, 0.05 is like my bare bottom. But I've built that on Samsung 25Rs and it's held up for me. But, you know, be weary. If you're new, then fuck, don't do that, you know, but for me, I've built, I know what I'm doing, I have an idea, I check everything with ohm testers, and it works well. So we talked about the Nemesis a bit. Back on track. Talked about the Nemesis. The H Cigar Nemesis was like my jam towards the beginning of the year. This was kind of a later on in the year thing. Like, when Atmo Mahani announced the Copper Nemesis, I was like fanboy list for 2 months. Like, when's it coming out? I need one. You know, I loved it that much. And I got one. I got serial number 187. This is the cloud killer. And it is beast. It hits very well when it's clean. A couple other things that really need, you know, to be stated. This is the Copper Cartel clone, and this is really easily accessible to a lot of people. When did this thing come out? I think around May or June. And my friend Tyler, you the man, brother. Tyler, who works at Dash Vapes, he manages the Dash Vapes at on Adelaide in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Hooked me up with one of these, and I think it was like $52. I forgot what it was. $56 or something like that. When no stores really had them yet. You know, they were pretty new. He got me one of these and I loved it. You know, I loved it. I loved the weightiness of it. I love the feel of it. Like, it was just, it's a nice clone. If you like a nice weighted, meaty kind of roll of quarters kind of mod, you would dig this. And I still use this occasionally. You know, I still use this occasionally. There is a bit of voltage drop. Not a ton. Like, it's not a bad mod by any means, but it doesn't hit as well as my copper Nemis do. Okay? So there's that. But it does hit super well, and this one was pretty close to my heart. Tyler, you're a good dude. Thank you, my brother. One more shot. Fuck, this is getting out of hand. I'm going to be a mess at the end of this. What else was there? Boy. Okay, we're getting to my favorite mod of the year. I'm going to talk about two more mods after in a couple of boxes, but my favorite tube mod, mechanical mod. Wow. Was this, and say what you will, I really honestly don't give a fuck. You know, whether you like it or you don't. I got my own opinions. Copper Manhattan from Amerivape. Okay. I did a review for the Brass Apollo not too long ago because it was available to me and I thought it was a great mod and I felt like it hit almost as well as the Manhattan. So I almost pulled the trigger. sorry, it's hard to choke down. I almost pulled the trigger on a Copper Apollo the other day, but I missed out on a 20% off sale and it kind of sucked. I was like 14 minutes late because I had a nap. Anyway, but Copper Manhattan is the jam. Like, there's nothing better in my personal opinion. This mod works so well. And I know some people watch my video and they're like, oh, you're trying to rescue fucking Amerivape? Who the fuck am I? You know what I mean? Like, who the fuck am I? Some dude with a couple thousand subscribers on my YouTube channel? I'm going to fucking rescue Amerivape? Fuck, man. They're going to do whatever the fuck they're going to do. I don't even talk to them. You know? Like, I don't. But the fucking Manhattan, the Copper Manhattan, is dope. Like, it is the best all-around mod for me. It hits well. The amount of cleaning that my Nemesis takes to keep hitting, the Manhattan doesn't need that. Like, I can clean it once a week and it's happy. You know? And it doesn't stop hitting. I've never had a misfire on it. I've never had issues on it. The only issues I've had is I've dropped it and I've dinged the shit out of it. But I've been able to, you know, either bend it back or just keep using it. You know? And that's it for me. You know, the Copper Manhattan is the jam. And I want to get the Copper Apollo, just, I don't want to pay full pot for it. You know? I don't want to pay full pot for it. That's just, because tube mods, in my opinion, are very overpriced. You know? Like, I understand there's R&D, and you got to pay your machinist, and you got to do this, and you got to make some money on your time. I understand. You know? But paying, you know, $200 and $300 on a tube mod is fucking ridiculous to me. And the thing with Amerivape is, fuck, I'll say it. I don't give a shit. I'm like halfway lit now. Amerivape, people have told me, oh, dude, you vape the Manhattan. That's your favorite thing. Like, really? You went a rung down on my ladder. Or that's your favorite thing? Like, really? And it's like, I like the mod. And it kind of freaked me out because the whole thing with Todd, I just thought, oh, it is what it is. Who gives a fuck, you know? Like, some people have a bad day or maybe it's misinterpreted. I don't give a shit. But then when, like, Amerivape posted, like, some weird fucking pictures on Instagram, like, Hitler-ish fucking terrorist fucking Twin Towers shit, I was like, fuck, really? I still gotta love this mod. I even watched a video where Eric fucking built, you know, like a 3-wrap or 4-wrap 20-gauge coil and then wicked it so fucking tight. And I was like, the only reason he's got to wick it so fucking tight is because the coils, they have to be fucking separated. Like, it has to be. It can't be a contact coil to wick that fucking thing. And I just watched it, and I was like, that is fucking brutal. And I still love the fucking Manhattan, you know? I still put a fucking captain's cap on it and loved it, you know? Like, no matter what. And that's how good the mod is, in my personal opinion. All right? So get off my back about it. Actually, there was a dude who kind of like player hated on me. His name was Maddie. Maddie D, was it? I don't remember. But he kind of fucking player hated on me for my AmeriVape video. I did the Copper Manhattan video. And he hated on me for it. And I was just like, I typed back like twice. And I was like, dude, you know what? You know, fuck, you know, this, whatever, that. And then I just fucking said, you know what? Forget it. You know, I don't give a shit. If you're going to troll, you're going to troll. I don't give a fuck. You know, and I guess, you know, some time went by and a couple months went by. And that guy actually apologized to me for what he said. You know, he was like, you know what? Your opinion's your opinion. And good on you. And then he apologized to somebody else, to a girl named Mandy, who, you know, kind of stuck up for me in that moment. And he apologized to her because he was kind of rude to her. So good on you, dude. You know, good on you, bro. Because, you know, this is what YouTube reviews are about. It's just opinion. It's just opinion. And I like it no matter what. You know, like, I just dig the mod. And I dug the Apollo. You know, I ordered a Skyline clone today because I wanted to see what it was about. You know, and I don't order a shit ton of clones. You know, and if I do, I kind of gotta like the stuff. You know, weird, right? Anyway, but yeah, cool on you, Maddie. Cool on you. You know what? I'm going to say the favorite comment that I had this year from any viewer was just not too long ago. Some dude said that I reminded him of the vaping Big Lebowski. And he was like, I think he was trying to say, I'm like the vaping dude, you know? And I thought that was like the coolest comment that I read. And I forget who you are, man, but that was a badass comment, man. Thank you. That's better than the comments I received like, hey, man, if you had a ohms calculator, you would know that, you know, that build is over 40 amps. And it's like, yeah, dude, I know. If you watch the whole video, I said that the pulsing rates of the battery were this. So, yeah, fuck off. Anyway, moving forward, man. Copper Manhattan, Dark Horse, usually live together. You know, they usually live together. The competition cap, the captain's cap, okay, even that old competition thing tweaks me out. Like, it just tweaks me out. But the captain's cap is living on the Manhattan lately just because it's 25 mil. Like, it works. If it doesn't live on this, it lives on an H Cigar Oros clone. And I've been digging this thing a lot. The voltage drop on this is slim to none. Slim to none. That's an H Cigar clone of it. Digging that a lot, man. I'll show it to you one more time. H Cigar Oros clone. I paid $42 Canadian for this, which is probably the equivalent of $36 US. You know, something like that. Pretty close. For $36 US, you can get a pretty badass mod. Kind of reminds me of the Valkyrie, the way that it slopes up. And it's pretty dope to use, like the lock ring on its boss. I haven't done a video for this. This is one of those things that I didn't feel like a video was necessary, you know? I got it and I used it and I posted pictures on my Instagram like I dig it, all right? Oh, shit. Let's get into a couple more mods. Fuck, this video is going to be super long, bro. Shot. These are like bigger than 1 ounce shots, too, you know? Pour one more for the road. My girlfriend's texting me. She's saying, need anything from Zaire's, which is our grocery store. Let me get to you in a minute, babe. Another mod that I absolutely dug a lot, and I loved it at first, and then I wasn't sure, and then I loved it again, was the Golden Armor Ember 26650. This is probably the most expensive mod that I've bought. You know, this retails for, I paid $280 Canadian. It's about $2.50 US, I guess. But it's a beast, man. It is a solid beast. Just the batteries hold it back. You know, the batteries I've been using are the AWTs and the vape power batteries. And I find the vape power batteries work super sick in it. If I try and throw an 18650 into it, it's kind of whack. You know, it just doesn't fit right. But I did order another battery to try out, which I think is going to work super good. I only ordered one just to see if it was good. Okay. What am I vaping in this? Kubrick's Custard on the Doge in single coil. $26,650. Single coil, and check out the clouds on this bitch, and then I'll tell you about the build. We'll talk about boxes and whatever after. Fuck, this is long, dude. Single coil. Bam! That's some like Homeboy OC, Twisted Messes kind of shit. Maybe not D'd Up Decks, because that guy does some different shit. But the coil that I'm rocking in this is clapped in paralleled with 22 gauge. I don't know if you can see it. I'll bring it right up. The clapped in part is 22 gauge nichrome, and it's wrapped in 36 gauge A1 canthal. And then I used the existing 22 gauge that was kind of at the base when I ran out of wraps to parallel it. So I'm doing four wraps of 22 gauge nichrome with a 22 gauge nichrome and 36 gauge canthal clapped in three wrapper in single coil 0.09. And it's fucking the beastest single coil that I've ever vaped. You know what? No drip tip allowed, man. Beast. And I'm using it with the friggin' Ember mod. This Ember mod is dope silver contacts. It's like 90 some odd percent pure silver contacts. This one also, you need to keep the contacts clean to keep it working well. But this was my favorite 26650 mod of the year by far. Hoping that my new battery just works super well, man. Super duper well. Went through a lot of the mods. Let's talk about, okay, we talked a little bit about the Hexome. The Hexome for regulated box mod, Hammond box, it's clean. You know, and a lot of people have been saying, oh, you can get that for $80 or whatever. Okay, fucking build it. You know what I mean? It's like $1.50. You know, like, it's cheap. I got the red detonator button. It's boss. I'm sure the version 2 is slick like Rick with a big dick. Now, another box. Oh, my man Jimmy. My man Jimmy down in Texas, in Temple, Texas, was cool enough to send me free of charge, man. Like, how cool is that? Is the 120 watt Raptor chip Hammond box. It's a little bit bigger than the Hexome, and it's got dual 18650 running in series just like the Hexome with the 120 watt Raptor chip in it. So it's a little more beast. And it's not the Fat Daddy 510. It's the one something that's close to it. Spring-loaded still. and it works like a Mac Daddy. You know, you put a build in this, you do maybe like a 26 gauge 7 wrap build on your dripper with this, and it is so good. So good. And I want to thank Jim, man, because I don't know if I thank that dude enough, and I kind of wanted to send that guy something, and I was so hoping that that dude was going to win the Quicksilver Dripper on the last contest, but he didn't, you know. I was really hoping, you know, but either way, like, Peter won it, and Peter's a good dude. Peter's a very, very good dude. But thank you, Jim, so much for sending me that. Man, I'm hot in the face now, man. The heat's not even on. It just feels warm because of this fireplace. Let's do a shot. Damn. Sasha's gonna be mad. Some of the other stuff, all right? Chaser, big time. So we looked at the 454, right? Sigelli, 100 watt. IPV version 3. The guys at Happy Vapor were cool enough to loan me these, and I still have them. You know, I shot a video as a comparison for these like 2 weeks ago, and I haven't given these back, and I feel like such a dill bag for it. You know, it's just, it's been busy. But Sigelli 100 watt, 150 watt IPV, I felt like it was the future. You know what I mean? Like, for a long time, we had, you know, 20, 30 watt devices, 40 watt, 50 watt came out, and it was like, oh my God, have you tried a 50 watt IPV? And it's like, oh my God, I'm building a fucking 200, you know? And sure, you know, it ramps down and whatever, but it only ramps down to like a buck 20. Like, so there's that. But I started vaping these boxes and I really dig them. And I did the comparison video and I picked the Sigelli, but either way, no matter what you pick, it's a good pick, you know? I've scuffed up the IPV so much more than the Sigelli that I think I'm going to keep this and just pay them for it. You know, that's just how I feel, you know? But hopefully they're cool with that, because I kind of scratched up the Sigelli as well. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so, so sorry. Man. Regulated boxes. Hitting very well. Let's move into the best Clearo of the year. And we're talking Clearomizer. We're not talking about rebuildable tank atomizer. Jenny's. Where did Genesis Addies go? I think next year there's going to be a Genesis atomizer that's going to kick some serious ass. Serious ass. Aspire came out with this bad motherfucker, man. And it's good. Like, the new, what is this thing? It's not the Nautilus. What the fuck is this thing? This Clearo vapes like a dream, okay? It vapes like a dream. 0.5 ohm coil in it. I've been vaping this thing. This is another thing that I'm not going to do a video on. Because I feel like it, I'm not going to do it justice. You know, it's not up my alley. It's a Clearomizer that's 0.5 ohm coil, and that's great. You know, if you're starting vaping, I think this guy is awesome. But for me to review it, it's not going to be super positive. But for a Clearomizer, you can't beat it. And I'm vaping it at 40 watts, which is 4.8 volts, and it holds up. Any higher than that, can't do it. And I was watching people's reviews saying, oh, it, you know what? It vapes like a dripper. Well, it depends on how you build your dripper. You know? It doesn't vape like my dripper does, but it vapes pretty solid, you know? And I've seen the coil makeup, and I think that it's a genius idea. And the coils have lasted me so much longer than my Nautilus did. Like my Nautilus, I was killing coils in about 6 days. And I thought it was lovely. Like one of the first videos that I shot was like first impressions for the Aspire Nautilus. And I was digging it. I was murdering coils in 6 days. I've been vaping the same coil in this with a 50-50 juice. I think I'm vaping, this is Lazarus number one. I've been vaping this. It's a 50-50 juice, I'm pretty sure. Maybe it's a 70-30. No, it's a 50-50 juice. Lazarus number one. For at least 3 weeks. And I've been vaping it pretty high. Like, I've never vaped it under 25 watts. And lately, over the last week and a half, I've been vaping it at 40 watts. It's awesome. The Nautilus coils were kind of shit compared to this. So, you know what? If you're going to get something, get the Atlantis. Like, the Atlantis is a pretty boss Clearo if you don't want to build coils. You know? And it's nice. You could sit and vape it on the couch with your girlfriend beside. Like, my girlfriend doesn't vape. She quit smoking without needing to vape. She just did it because she was, you know, in healthcare and whatever. She's a nurse. And she just quit, and good on her, you know? But I can vape that around her and not have her get too pissed off at me. Time for a shot. Fuck, I'm getting ruined on this video. So there's that, you know, like we talked a lot about tube mods, regulated box, and shit like that. I've got an unregulated box coming, I hope, man, from a Canadian company, and I'm super ecstatic about it because I just am. Like, I don't want to share too much if it doesn't end up happening. Like, I don't want everyone to be heartbroken if it doesn't happen, but whatever. It's pretty sick. Like, some of the wood. Okay, here it is. You know, I talked to this company. It's a Canadian company. I'll say what it is. It's Apex Custom Mods. And Apex Custom Mods was making some stuff out of wood, but they were finding that their wood was cracking. So they didn't want that. They wanted, you know, you to be happy with it. It's kind of like all these Camagong wood stuff, like mods coming out of Philippines, and then they send it over here to like the northern US and Canada where the temperature gets colder, it's more humid, whatever, and it cracks and it breaks. Like, I've seen so many pictures of people re-gluing their mods that it shouldn't be that way. And with Apex and the dudes over there, they don't want that. You know, they want you to get a mod that's just beast as fuck. And fuck, I hope they send that to me, man. I really do. I've been waiting on it like, you know, it's God's gift, right? But whatever. Did we talk about the Orchid? The Orchid was my favorite tank. Favorite tank of the year. I got a Squape R clone from Vape Dominion. Those guys were cool enough to send me one free of charge. And it's pretty sick. It's pretty sick. But it's a single coil device, kind of like a K-Fun. Let's talk about tanks then. Okay, at the beginning of the year, I had a K-Fun. I had K-Fun clones. And I had a K-Fun 3.1. K-Fun 3, whatever it is. And like the full-size K-Fun. And I dug it. You know, and I was really digging building a single coil, you know, and I could take that thing to work. And it was great, man. And I got a K-Fun Lite Plus in April. I loved it. Like, I loved it. I thought it was a great vape just to take with me for the day. It's not like, you know, it's not a clouding beast, but it was a good vape. And I saw a lot of cool things come and go this year. Squape Reloaded, I'm going to give it this. Easy as shit to build. Like, all you got to do is wrap on a similar diameter as that deck slot. Psh, wrap your leads around those screws and tighten it down. Boom. You're off to the races. Wicked. Squape Reloaded. Ease of use, awesome. Orchid. Dual coil, sick. Sick. The vape I got from the Orchid when I got it blew my head off. I've actually got a billow tank on the way. Ordered it today along with the AmeriVape Skyline clone and some other stuff. And I'm pretty excited about that. Like, Trevor Jones is my dude. And you know what? Trevor Jones is the nicest, coolest guy on earth. Okay, if you're watching my channel and you haven't watched Trevor Jones, watch his channel. But leave him the fuck alone, because he's my friend. Alright? No, I'm just kidding. That guy is nice as shit. You know, like, he is the coolest friggin' dude out there. Love that dude, Trevor Jones. You are my brother from another mother. You know, beyond a doubt. Another guy I want to shout out is Z Vapor. Z Vapor lives close to me. Z Vapor shouted me out on his video for the Eric. Z, why don't you just send me your Eric? I don't want to have to buy one. Anyway, cool shit. Those dudes are awesome, man. Awesome dudes. Some of the other videos I like to watch. Matt and Vanessa, I like those guys. Like, I like them a lot. Candy McCann, I like her. Chris Wicks, I like Chris Wicks. His juice reviews are fucking sick, man. Who else? Todd. Other than that, I don't watch a shit ton of videos, man. I don't. Big Lou East Coast Review, I watch some of his videos. Some of them. Like, everybody's got their forte. And I think everybody's got their own style and what they like. And there's certain reasons to watch people's channels, you know? And if you're watching my channel, I think if you like building a low res and you like knowing what's a good build in something, like, you know, you buy a dark horse, what's the best build to put in it? Watch my video. I think it's going to help you out. But some people just have, like, a talent for, you know, juice reviews. Or they have a talent for showing you something, you know? Like, this is the mod, check it out. This is how it is, you know? I'm not talented at that, I just do it. Anyway, moving forward, I'm going to have a shot. We're almost close to the end of this thing. It's been nice hanging out with you guys. Happy New Year! Pour one more for the dead homies. Fucking Don Julio's not that fucking sweet. Juices and builds. We're almost there, guys. Juices and builds. One of the things that I really love this year, I built a lot of coils using, you know, Japanese cotton or, you know, Shishido. I built some Kogendo stuff, Koga stuff. But my favorite wicking material right now is this shit, and it's like $6 a pack. Cotton bacon is my favorite thing. You know, once you figure it out and how much to rip off, how to even it out, this is the jam. You know, like, it doesn't get better than that. You know, it doesn't get better than that. And for builds, my favorite build this year has obviously been 20-gauge build. I said it earlier. Whether it's nichrome or canthol, it's my favorite build. But other than that, the Monster Tiger build. No one watches it on my channel. Monster Tiger build is bar none the best build that you could put into any 22 mil atomizer. Like, it's the best build to make flavor. You could make the flavor of a Veritas in a Patriot from that Monster Tiger build. Like, there is no doubt about it. Do that build. My next favorite build. Oh my god. Okay, I did the Clapton build that I showed you guys, right? But my next favorite that I just kind of discovered, besides Tiger Coils, there's a lot of variations of Tiger Coils that I like. 24 gauge Tiger Parallel is wicked. But watching dudes like Homeboy OC and Twisted Messes, and there's a handful of others, you know, there's a handful of those Builds Brigades dudes. I decided to do 20 gauge Nichrome Core with a Tiger Coil Clapton around it. So the Tiger Coil is 36 gauge Canthal and 0.8 ribbon. So there's a lot more ribbon wire in the Tiger than there is round wire. So I wrapped up the Tiger wire and then Claptoned it around the 22 gauge Nichrome Core, and it is just ridiculous. It's, I don't want to say it's better than the Monster Tiger build, but it is a little bit different and better at the same time. Like, it is sick as fuck. I put it in the dark horse. It's sick. Dude, think about this build, okay? You clapped in a Tiger Coil around 22 gauge Nichrome. I was thinking about doing it with 24 gauge, kind of like a fuse clapped in. But I thought the resistance was going to be slightly too low if I did that. Maybe it wasn't, but fuck, it's ridiculously flavoricious. 22 gauge Nichrome wrapped with 36 gauge Canthal and 0.8 ribbon wire clapped in. It's sick. And I did 5 wraps dual coil, and it is, I think it beats out the Monster Tiger, and it might be the way of 2015. It's Flavor City, and it bucks clouds. Like, it's not a bitch build. Like, a lot of times when there's like Clapton builds and stuff, they're kind of like punk ass bitch builds. And you know what? I've watched Twisted Mess's channel on YouTube. Check him out. If you're into building, he does some great builds. But when you watch his channel, he'll tell you. He'll be like, you know what? This is kind of an artsy build. Or this is kind of, you know, for looks only, but it gives you this. And he's honest about it. And I dig that. It's not like watching other people's channels where it's like, you know what? This is the best build you could do. Check it out and do it. You know, because it's not. And like my channel, I try to give you the best possible build for what you're doing. You know, if you like what I do. And this build, I'm thinking beats out the Monster Tiger build. It does. It does. And the Monster Tiger build is very close to my heart for the last year, man. Because it heats up like a 22 gauge coil, but it's got that flavor machine, you know, going with it. You can make your dark horse taste like a plume veil, you know, you can. And I think, like, I watch Rip's videos and stuff, And no offense on Rip, because Rip taught me a lot of shit. But, like, Rip's really set on, this is the way that I build, this is the way that atomizers work, and this is what is good. I think that you could take any atomizer to a different level. You know? Like, I just feel like, if you want to take the Dark Horse to a fucking Veritas level, you can. And this build is sick. It is so sick. So sick. Let's get into it. Some more fucking shit. I'm rambling, man. That build is retarded. I actually might do a build video for that. I might do one, but I still have... I'm going to do the 18-gauge build video. I'm going to do the Kayfon build video before I do that build video, I think. You know, because I think that I've been saying them for a long time. Cheers. Happy New Year! Juices. Let me just get into juices because we're going too fucking long on this. Builds, Dignam Claptons, I think they might be the way of 2015 for me. I just got to figure it out completely. You know, like, I think I need to wrap thick density nichrome wire with, you know, really thin camphor wire to get my flavor banged out. And that's it. Now for juice, Charlie from Vape Meat, and that guy owns Vape Meat in Brampton, Ontario, Canada. He can do no wrong, in my personal opinion. I vaped a shit ton of OMC this year. OMC was my jam. Like, it was what it was. And big ups to you, man. Toronto Juice Company. OMC, man. Oh My Custard was the shit. I started making juice this year, and what I tried to do was replicate OMC. That was it for me, you know? And I did different things, you know? I ended up with different things that weren't quite OMC, and I think that's kind of neat. And I think I might share some of those with you guys in the new year, you know? And they're going to be really good juices. I'm not going to give you shit, you know? That's just the way that it is. Another guy, actually, you know what, we'll keep talking about Charlie. Charlie was dope. Funk Sauce, he hooked it up. Toronto Juice Company, Funk Sauce, Captain Oliver's. I've been vaping the Admiral Cavendish. Ridiculously good juice. Ridiculously good juice. These are some of my favorites this year, besides my own. And, another one that I've really, really dug is Juice by Kubrick. Juice by Kubrick. He's a dude from Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. His custard is just different, you know? But it's tasty. And I've vaped stuff from Florida to California to Ontario to British Columbia, you know? So I've vaped some stuff along the way, and I think that Juice by Kubrick is one of those things that is not known to a lot of people, but oh my shitstorm, it is fucking good. I wish I had some OMC to shut it down with, but I don't. I've got Admiral Cavendish, which is a ripe banana pudding, and it is so good, man. It is so good. I've been vaping it for... the better part of this whole video, and it's so good on this on some of these Tiger Coil builds and Clapton builds, Tigered Clapton builds, it is just ridiculous the flavor that you pull out of it. And whether you're vaping it on a contact coil at 24 gauge or 28 gauge or whatever you like, I think you would really dig this juice, you know? So that's pretty much it, you know? Like, it's really, really cool to have you guys. And I want to thank you guys for all the support, you know? Like, it is chill, it is cool. and I really appreciate it, you know? So one more shot, and I think we're done, you know? I think we talked about everything. And I would have to say this is probably the longest vlog video that I've shot, and I hope it helped you guys out. As always, hanging out in front of the fireplace with the Christmas tree. And those things are going down tomorrow, the next day. All the best, my friends. Like I always say, guys, butt out, vape up, and breathe easy. Know your limits and vape within it. And you, my friend, are going to have a stellar day. Thanks for chilling out, guys. It's been nothing but a slice, my friends. Chilling out with the, you know, the dude of the vape industry. You know? Cool enough, man. Keep stomping your feet and rocking to the beat. All right? Okay, I'm going to show you this one more time. 22 gauge nichrome core, and it's claptoned with 36 gauge canthal and 0.8 ribbon. You wrap those, the 0.8 ribbon and 36 gauge really tight to where it's like there's almost like bubbles, like beads in it. And you clapton that around the 22 gauge. And when you first start vaping it, it kind of beads and spits. But after about like 6 hours, it evens out and just disperses a wicked vape. All right, guys. So that's it. I'll do a tutorial on that in the new year if I have continued success with it. Thank you so much. Happy New Year, my friends, and all the best in 2015. All right? Babe, you want to be in the video?
No.
Come on.
Do I have to say anything?
Yeah, put your face in. Here's my honey.
Okay. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, vapors.